Right. So, I'm going to take a minute and just see where the world stands after this. Surely the Russians and the Austrians have to attack each other eventually. I mean, not Austrians, Ottomans. Like, surely. I mean, Russia's got claims all over them. Austria is now, like, boned. Because Bohemia is just blobbing up here hardcore. And they're the emperor now. So I don't think there will be much to stop the great Bohemian blob that we have here. See how Denmark... Denmark is still willing to help. Which sucks. So... can't really attack anybody right now. Except maybe natives, I don't know. Let's, though... I feel like we should be looking for more allies. So it's still just me, the Commonwealth, and Great Britain as reformed. And Switzerland down here. This isn't bad. I don't know if they want to be my ally, though. Because I'm kind of far away from them. I don't know if they'd be able to help me, to be honest. Heck, maybe if Scotland could be a valuable ally in the future, actually, if they, like, form a nice empire and become strong again, I could use them. I don't know. We'll see. Let's speed it back up here again. Let's actually get our armies back together as well. Still losing so much money here. Stupid colonies just won't finish. This one's gonna be at least 4 more years, it looks like. At the minimum. I mean, most. At the maximum. This one, 5 more years. Scotland's down here in, South America as well. France, it looks like they might aim for Argentina area. Portugal got South Africa. So I'm sure they'll show up in the Pacific as well. I guess Castile and Aragon never did the binding dynasty thing. So Aragon allied with... maybe Aragon would want to be my ally. Never mind. Unlikely. I could try to reform my alliance with Bohemia, which would honestly be the smartest thing to do, I'm sure. Because they're not enemies with the Commonwealth. Or Brandenburg. So I might be able to get them back as my ally, since they left me earlier. I don't know how much longer the Commonwealth is going to survive. Another attack by Russia, and I'm sure the Ottomans as well. And they'll be closing in on their last breath. At least, you know, relevant breath. I still need just to finish taking Sweden. So probably Stockholm and Bergslagen would be my next two obvious targets. If we can take Stockholm, that'll be great. Direct them to an existing colony. So we just got a year's worth of colonists in Stadacona here. So that's nice. That's at 876. Here we're at 885. Which idea can we get? Global tariffs? So I'm gonna hold off on that, even though I'm losing money. Still very fast. Over 2 per turn. Gosh, I really don't understand why Denmark had to be allied with Norway. Like, why? Why Denmark? And I'm kind of hoping that Denmark actually inherits Sweden, because I think it might make it easier for me to attack them. Might not, though. They do have a positive chance, so I mean, it could happen at some point. Well, Russia's going back to the east for now. So, probably leave us alone for a bit. Actually, I think Neva's our only. Well, there goes our rivalry with Russia. Until my diplomat is at max relations with Bohemia, and then yes, got the colony done, which is really nice. So finally I'll be making money again, and I can send my colonists here to help him finish out that. I'm not spending that much money. Alright. So Kesbeck should be done soon too, and we're back positive. And once Kesbeck is done, we'll be making pretty good money. I can finally pay off one of my now 5 loans. Oh, yeah. Norway has gone bankrupt, which, you know, doesn't really help me, because Denmark is still protecting them, and until I can get probably Great Britain back to help me, I don't know if... Just because of their navy, if nothing else. I mean, I might be able to win with just Brandenburg helping me, but... unsure. Let's maintain the diplomat. And go to... We'll finish off our Scandinavian provinces here. Can't quite get the royal marriage, so let's go to our advisors. And we don't have a... diplomatic reputation advisor. So allows to get a royal marriage with Bohemia, which would then put us across the line for an alliance. So I think... And the gift will not do it either. Alright, Kesbeck is now self-sustaining as well. And... we'll be making that good money. Now, I'm not going to send another colonist yet, because I do want to just get some money going here. That goes to Gulf of St. Lawrence, goes to the North Sea. What's our trade power like in the North Sea? 8%. Alright, so Great Britain is now finally ready to go to war with Denmark and Norway. So, even though I don't have any of my loans paid off, let's go ahead and start raising some army maintenance and, let's get my ships back. And we're gonna start the war. Now, I don't need to split up my army a whole lot, because Norway did go bankrupt, so they're not gonna have any morale whatsoever when fighting. I can actually... I think I might get some more units here. I can hold 27 now. So as soon as they're all done training... Actually, I don't need to wait. So let's take out a couple here. Just 3 infantry will be fine. Board them up. war started. So let's call in our allies. Take Utuk. And let's go. So Denmark, Sweden are gonna join in. Actually, probably should have waited until my units are ready. Alright, so let's land here. Faroe Islands. Let's go to Stockholm first. The Swedish army's over there. Danish army's kind of, I don't know where they're going. Actually, we're kind of unsafe because I did forget a general in my army again. So let's just get back to our territory real quick. Get a general. It will do. And now we can go back. Okay, so Faroe Islands are ours. Actually, this will be quicker if we just do this. Let's get that. Head on over to Newfoundland. So Brandenburg, they're down here at the Palatinate, obviously. What should we take for our fourth idea? I'm thinking maybe trade, so we can get merchants. Over in our American colonies. So I think I'm gonna do that actually. Cause dim extra merchants can be pretty useful. Especially when you got a colonial empire. Alright, so we're just, Denmark's kinda going around, not really doing a whole lot. A nice 14 on that roll. They're going down to Stockholm. And they probably would be my army, to be honest, but... And there's a 1. I don't know, Sweden. There's Olbo. Got a 10 there. That's a, got a 20% chance. So we'll see if Denmark comes for us. They're going to Östergötland, actually. So no, right now. Let's go check back over here. We haven't made it. We can land. But I've got to keep an eye over here, because this is the main part of the war. Denmark might be going down to fight Brandenburg, which would be fine with me. Because they would probably lose, actually. Alright, so they'll be there in a few days. Oh my gosh, come on. Thank you. Alright, so Sweden's actually down there. So we probably have to go over there and help our capital. Because we definitely don't want that to fall. No, I don't... Okay, yeah, Norway does have down here in Mexico. But in all honesty, I don't care. Norway can have that part of the world. So I don't need to take that from them. I'm just going to concern myself with what they have in the Atlantic, and also Sweden and Denmark, of course. Now, if the Danish army doesn't leave, they would come and help. They'd come and help Sweden if I were to attack them, which would not be good, because then I would lose. And the British army still continues to do absolutely nothing, and I don't know where Brandenburg went. So, don't really know what we're doing here in this war, because I really need the Danish army to go away. Yeah, there goes my capital. But I think we can easily take it back. I mean, it's a pretty small garrison. Alright, so let's get our troops back here. We should be able to sail around with impunity since we got the British Navy on our side. And I think the Brandenburg Navy's even better than the Danish Navy now. If the Danish Navy even has anything left, they got 10 ships left, so that's nothing. Hopefully we get our cap back soon. We can take back Obo as well. Sweden's gonna go try to take back Finland. Still don't know where the Brandenburg army is. Oh, there they are. They're in Holstein. They're gonna go work on Kolding now. We actually get some upgraded artillery, so that'll be helpful. Chambered demi cannon. Nope, not quite. Oh my god, come on. Go away, Norway. I need to take land from Denmark. Jeez, finally. Get our troops back on land. Let's go block the port so we can get the bonus there. What are you offering me? No. I highly doubt I can get anything from Sweden on this peace deal. No, because I don't have anything occupied. If I do go occupy Stockholm, then... well... then I might be able to get some stuff. Did Brandenburg really lose that? They had way more morale. That stinks. I mean, heck, it's looking like we're not going to be able to get much more here, to be honest. Norway's back on high. Yeah, they're not... ah, I probably should have taken that peace deal when I could have, actually. Starting to hope this war just doesn't start going bad for us. I need to get over there and kill the Swedish army before they take Trondelag. Alright, so we got that back. Let's get over here quick. I'm sure they'll take it on this one, though. Nope, they got a one. Idiots. Whatever. Yep, no, now they took it, yeah, of course. Gosh, let's just go to Stockholm. British Army finally decided they want to come help. So let's get Stockholm here. If we get that, then we might be able to take a little bit from Sweden. I'm trying to get back colder. Commonwealth's having all sorts of problems down there. Gosh, we're just... This war has turned not great for us. Because Norway took that back, of course. But now, well, now Sweden just got annexed, which actually kind of doesn't help me. Because Stockholm's suddenly not a important city anymore. Jeez. I'm still going to go in there. I need to take another few units. We need to get back over here and retake that, because that's an issue. Okay, let's go. Well, hopefully if Sea Island falls, then that'll put a hurt on Denmark. Let's go to Elfsborg, though. Start working on that. That's a big army, though. That might be coming straight for us. No, they're turning away. Gosh, how did this war start going so freaking bad so quickly? I don't know where Denmark's going. We did just get Shiland, so they're not even willing to give me anything, though. I think my best choice of action. Let's just take that, because I don't want to be spending a whole lot more money, and, you know, I'm just taking out so many loans here, it's kind of getting ridiculous. I need to just, you know, try to consolidate a bit. Mothball our forts. Turn off army maintenance. Alright. So that war did not go as well as I hoped it would, but I mean, we at least gained our goal. Finish off the rest of that. And we can also go to Iceland now if we so choose. Norway. I guess they'll just continue to exist down here. -165. Yeah, Norway might just be this one province for the rest of the game. We'll see. Let's get our navy back to protecting our trade. Jesus. My army maintenance, man. I could even take the Shetland Islands from Scotland, which I probably should. Then from Scotland. Scotland can just be Virginia, since that's what it looked like they're going for. Then you got Baltimore down here. Maryland. Well, I think that'll be a good place to stop. Wherever, oh, I totally forgot about Bohemia. Yeah, they're still not interested. I'm gonna keep them there just because, in case an opportunity pops up for me to ally them. Yeah, I think that's gonna be a good place to stop. So, not a super productive episode except for the beginning or whatever. But I don't know. Yeah.